Hi, my name is Matthew Rocknich. I am a developer evangelist here at DocuSign. I'm here today with Mike Roseleip, who is a development manager. Mike, thank you so much for being on the show.
Thanks, Matt.
So Mike, how long have you been in the software world?
I started in software in 1985, so it's been quite a while.
Wow.
Yeah, I started it right out of college at Boeing.
Yeah.
And back then we were working with a lot of Unix workstations, and Boeing had every brand imaginable. So yeah, our job was to write graphics libraries that would work across those different stations and let you build apps on top of it in just one like abstract layer. Pretty cool. But I was there for about 10 years. I did a lot of other projects too, but after that I moved to a small startup in Seattle called Primus, and there I met some of the people I work with today. We did knowledge-based software for sort of help desk systems. I did a lot of API integration there. After that, I moved to Siemens Ultrasound in Issaquah, and there we created the next generation of ultrasound machines that Siemens produced. So yeah, I did a lot of UI development, kind of mid-level stuff, everything above the actual low-level software that runs ultrasound machines.
Nice.
Everything the user sees. So it was pretty fun,
yeah.
A lot of fun.
And then how long have you been at DocuSign?
Almost 9 years.
9 years.
Yeah, it's been pretty exciting. When I started, the engineering team was about 8 people. We worked on everything, so everyone had a part-time job that was basically everything we did.
That's so cool.
I started out, I worked on DocuSign for Salesforce. I worked on the integrator key concept. One of my first projects was to add like the Dropbox integration and integrations to what we call the classic console now, and build out our core logic. I then moved on to the REST API. So
excellent.
I started working on the REST API 6 or 7 years ago,
so cool.
Adding the first function, and then we added more people.
Yeah.
And we built V2, the REST API, and it's been growing and evolving ever since.
Excellent. So you have a unique perspective having been here for 9 years. What, in your opinion, what's the one thing that brings you to work every day? Like, what's the best part about developing at DocuSign?
Well, I think working with the people is the best thing. I mean, we have a really dynamic, fun group of engineers that love to create new things and love to work together. It's always fun. It's always exciting to be here.
Yeah. So most recently, what have you been working on?
I'm working on something new. So I stepped away from the API just recently, and I'm working on a new software that will support our new agreement cloud concept.
Secret stuff.
Secret stuff.
Secret
yeah.
stuff. Okay. And then last thing you worked on the API team was what?
Right, with v2.1.
Okay, awesome.
So v2.1 is really the result of years of developing an API that we used internally to reimagine our web console. So when you log into DocuSign and you're creating envelopes and you're sending with templates and all the things, that's called the DocuSign experience, and that's created on the v2.1 software. Along the way, over these past years, we've been moving some of those features into v2, but there comes a point where you can't just move everything because there's incompatibilities, and that's really where versioning takes place.
Gotcha. So I know there's a ton of different functions and improvements that we brought to v2.1. Mm-hmm. What are the top three things that you'd like to talk about related to v2.1?
Well, I mean, top three features are bulk send is really improved. In v2, you could only send using one recipient, but in v2.1, you can have multiple recipients, multiple tab options. You have a lot more flexibility for sending a large number of envelopes based on one template in a list.
Awesome.
It's really great.
And then second one?
Second one is our move towards better authentication. In V2, and we supported this in V2 too, but really moving towards a standard OAuth authentication that's more secure and allows you to create applications that are maybe all client-based, not have a server side.
Right.
That's really exciting.
Great. And then number three?
Number three, advanced support for, say, tabs and templates.
Okay.
So a lot of the features you have in V2, you really had to work with the console to get some of the templates, but you can actually make all those API calls now. Basically, anything that you see in the web console, you should be able to do in the software.
Very cool. So there are a ton of awesome features. Let's laser focus in on the last, and that is envelope queries. Can you show us a demo of them live?
Yeah.
Perfect.
Yeah, I'll show you from our demo system. So on this left side, I have the V2 envelope queries, and on the right side, I have V2.1, just to show the difference.
Perfect.
So the URLs are the same. I just put the same URLs in, even though some of the query string parameters are v2.1 specific.
Okay.
It'll just be ignored in the v2 case. So I'm going to send this off, and you'll see here's what comes back from getting a list of envelopes. So this is the get envelopes call, and you get kind of the short list for every envelope in v2. Now if you look at the v2.1 call, you get a bigger list. So you get a list per envelope. It's a bigger list of information. And what's interesting here is things like all of the different dates. So what's that envelope status? It was created, when it was sent, when it was last modified. That's kind of at the top level now.
That's awesome.
So yeah, you can get that information, and that's the kind of thing that in our web experience we would show when you go to like the manage page and you say, what are my envelopes? You know, which ones have I created? You can also, because of some of those query string parameters, you can get what folders that envelope lists in. So in the web console, when you choose the folders, that's how they get that information, and now that's available to v2.1 callers as well. We also put recipient information in here, and so you can see who are the recipients as part of that high-level structure.
Excellent.
So that's just some of the features of the new v2.1 get envelopes call. Other features are like chunking, so you can get chunks of envelopes at a time instead of waiting for the big list of envelopes, and that's really important if you have a lot of envelopes in your system.
High volume. Yeah.
Let's switch over to just a single envelope call. So getting a single envelope, you get sort of a little bit more information in V2 than you did in the list format. But in V2.1, you can ask for a lot more. So in V2.1, I've added parameters to get things like tabs and folders and recipients. And so now, in the V2.1 case, I see the folders like I did before, but I also see the recipients. I see information about them, and I also see what tabs they have and the status and the values of every tab. So you can see, like in this, is you've got this is a signature tab, and so you get information about all the tabs that are with that. So you don't have to make as many API calls. If you're getting a single envelope and all of the information about it, you should be able to call the v2.1 get envelope call, get more information. So that's kind of the theme for it with a lot of the v2.1 calls is more information.
Consolidation in a
single
call.
More information inbound, more information outbound, but the formats have changed. And so we can't really do that in v2 and be backward compatible.
Gotcha.
We have to move to a new version
Makes
to support
sense.
That. Another example of that is the get account settings. So in v2, you'll see the account settings was just a big list. And you would have to kind of iterate through this list to find the properties.
Yeah.
And you would never know what the property names really were. Right, they're just added in, and you would see new ones if you looked, and they showed up. In v2.1, all the properties are as structures. So you see a structured response. These are built into a class. If you use our SDKs, those classes will have all those properties. You can look at them up front. You can go to the documentation and see what values they might have. You can also get metadata. So in this case, you'll see some metadata that says, "Hey, I can edit this. I can actually send a new value for that property in, or if it's read-only, it tells me I can't do that."
As opposed to trial and error before.
That's right. If you send it in, you might get an error before.
Right.
And so you wouldn't know until after you send it. If there's a property that has multiple values, it'll list the potential values that you can send in, so you don't have to guess at those values
anymore. Yeah, there you go.
So that's a nice feature. And I'll just show it. It's the same thing for user settings. So here's the list again at the user level, getting all the information. You don't know what the properties are. In v2.1, you have the whole list and you see all the information. And that's a structure again. And I want to show that metadata can be turned off. So if you don't care about updates, you're just using that data, you know, to see what your user can do, you can set this to false or remove the parameter and get rid of all that metadata, so you just get the cleaner list of here's the properties.
Beautiful.
And here's the values.
Love that.
So yeah.
All right, so if there are any developers out there in the community want to access 2.1, head over to developers.docusign.com. We have guides and getting started. But other than that, Rosie, thanks so much for being here.
You're welcome.